Hello. I am going to do something very different today. Something I didn't think I'd ever do. I actually asked myself, what is the thing I would least want to do on one of these videos? Like, the thing out of everything that would be that I would not want to do. And actually the answer was pretty obvious to me from the beginning. And it is sing publicly on a video. That's exactly what I have to do, because I don't want to get over it. Just go for it. That's what I will do. I chose a Finnish hymn, so at least you won't know the song, most of you, so you wouldn't know if I do horribly badly. Well, I think everyone will know if I do horribly badly, but here goes. Glory to God. It's good enough for him. When I sing. Yes. Maunin kaunis, kirkas luo. Actually, it wasn't nearly as bad as I thought. I mean the experience, I'm not sure about the singing. So now I just have to upload this thing. Oh, and a brother from Canada wanted me to say hi to him and his family from Saskatchewan, Canada. So, hi there. The Lord is doing great things in your life. Just keep trusting him and walking with him. Surrender everything to him. Submit to him completely and walk with him daily. He's got you. And he will see you through anything and everything. And everything will be well. trust the Lord Jesus, he loves you so much. God bless you and your family, you're all in my prayers. And God bless everyone watching. The Lord uses our weaknesses for strength, to show his strength. He turns things around. Like Moses. Moses wasn't an eloquent public speaker. He had a stutter. He didn't want to take on the role he was given at all. He had a stutter. Did you realize that? He wasn't like this eloquent, suave public speaker. No! But he's the one God chose. And God used him to show his strength, his glory, his power. Glory to God. He's so amazing. Actually, this video just got longer because there's something that's been on my mind lately. In Matthew, in the parable of the talents, Jesus says, "Well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of your Lord." So Jesus is acknowledging there that this servant has truly made him Lord, has obeyed him. And then in Luke, Jesus says, Why call ye me Lord, Lord, and do not the things I say? So here the Lord Jesus is saying, why do you call me Lord if you don't obey me? How am I the Lord of your life if you don't obey me? Just calling me Lord won't do it. Serious words from the Lord Jesus. And what shows that we love God? That we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. It's a joy and an honor and a privilege and a pleasure to obey, to keep his commandments, to do what he says. And he helps us in our weakness. He carries us through. He's kind and loving and forgiving. But we have to do our best. We have to carry our cross. We have to surrender. We have to surrender to him, to submit to him, to let him truly be Lord of our lives. The Son of Man did not come to be served. He came to serve. And no servant is greater than their master. We live to serve. We live to serve God and each other. A servant heart is so important. An attitude of service. It's not about us, it's about the Lord. We have been created by God and for God, for his purposes, for his glory. And what else could there possibly be to live for than for the glory of God, than for the Lord Jesus? We deserve death and destruction, and he gave us life. He gave us love. He gives us all good things. He gave us an eternity, all eternity with himself. Wow. How would it possibly be too much to obey him, to live like he tells us to live, to honor him, to love him? Love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your strength, all your mind. And all your soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. Is that it? Guess so. God bless everyone. See you. Doo-doo-doo.